tell you a story. Oh, 2007, right? It was a little rainy out. It was the Boston Freedom Rally. It was just like this, 11 o'clock in the morning. I'm setting up the booth. My good friend Keith Strout with Normal High Times booth. We always put it together. I'm setting it up. He says, "Hey, Rick, before we get started, you want to go smoke a joint?" When I was 18 years old, this guy was on TV testifying for marijuana smokers to the federal government. My mother goes, "Look, there's your friend." Little did she know, 30 years later, she was right. He says, "You want to go smoke a joint?" I said, "Yeah, let's go smoke a joint." We get about halfway down the joint. A kid half our age pops his head on my shoulder. I thought he wanted to hit. He said, "You're arrested." And I got arrested with my hero, Keith Strout, 2007 at the Boston Freedom Rally. That sounds like a drag, but it wasn't a drag. We spent the next 2.5 years fucking around with them in court with a lot of help. Dr. Lester Grinspoon, Harvard, Charles Nesson, Harvard Law School. We took it all the way. We asked the Supreme Court of Massachusetts to hear our case. They refused. They said we were guilty. In the meantime, they decriminalized weed in Massachusetts. That was 2007. Last year, me and Keith were on the stage at the Boston Freedom Rally where we got busted for a third of a joint. And me and him did the countdown, and 20,000 Bostonians smoked marijuana all at the same time. Introduce to you the founder of the National Organization for the Reform of Marijuana Laws, one of the hardest working, smartest marijuana activists in the whole world, my friend, my mentor, my hero, and my co-defendant, ladies and gentlemen, Keith Strout. Thank you.
I assure you, it was my honor to be busted with Rick Cusick from High Times. We've been friends and allies with High Times since the earliest years. I was friends with Tom Frasaud, the smuggler that founded High Times magazine. So there's nothing more appropriate. If they want to bring the heat on, I'll be standing there with the High Times folks. Yeah! I want to tell you the simple truth. I smoke pot and I like it a lot. I'm a 68-year-old lawyer. I first smoked marijuana when I was a freshman at Georgetown Law School, and I've been a regular smoker ever since. The principle we stand for at Normal is that there is absolutely nothing wrong with the responsible use of marijuana. There's nothing wrong with smoking pot, period. In fact, we like to sometimes point out that, you know, we all know pot makes music sound better, food tastes better, sex feel better. Those aren't bad things in and of themselves. But I think it's even more than that. I think for most of us, in the right setting, the marijuana experience is a very enriching experience. And we need to have the courage to stand up and say that. There's nothing wrong with smoking pot. One of the reasons that we need for people to come out of the closet is that obviously we have to overcome some negative stereotypes left over from the 50s and the 60s, and mostly people my generation that didn't understand that marijuana was a much safer drug than the drugs that they were using. And the only way they're going to see that is for us to come out of the closet. It's a lesson I think the gays and lesbians learned well and did a terrific job. When I started Normal, gays and lesbians were about the same place we were. There were 12% of Americans supported legalization when we started Normal. By the way, today, it's over 50% of the public support full legalization, not just medical use. So again, come out of the closet if you can do it. I don't want you all to lose your jobs or be thrown out of school, but if you're independent, if you work for yourself, if you're a lawyer, whatever, and you can do it, stand up, get up, stand up, light up, and let the world know how you feel. Now, a little bad news. Marijuana prohibition results in roughly 855,000 marijuana arrests every year in this country. 855,000. There have been 20 million marijuana smokers arrested just since 1965. There's another marijuana smoker arrested roughly every 38 seconds in America. It is time we stopped arresting and started respecting responsible marijuana smokers. We are wasting roughly $9 billion a year in law enforcement resources chasing marijuana smokers. Law enforcement resources that could be focused on serious and violent crime. But prohibition is bad for some other reasons too. It invites the police into your life. I don't want the police coming into my house to know what books I read, what music I listen to, how I conduct myself in the bedroom, or whether I smoke marijuana or drink alcohol when I relax in the evening. It's none of your damn business. Now, the good news. The good news is that we took that 12% support we had the year Normal was founded in 1970, and now we enjoy the support of a majority of the American public. Folks, we have literally won the hearts and minds of more than 50% of the country nationwide. That means in states like Washington and Oregon and California and Colorado, we're up around 52 or 55 or 56%. So I assure you, we are going to win this. The only question is how soon and what form. You people in Washington have a very unique opportunity this November. If you're registered to vote, you know you will have the chance to fully legalize marijuana in Washington State in November. And do it, folks. Do it. We have full legalization initiatives on the ballot in Colorado, in Oregon, and here in Washington. And I assure you that if one or two or all three of those pass, and I sure as hell hope they do, it will be momentous. It will change the whole world of drug policy. There is nothing we can do to force the federal government to finally take their heads out of the sand more effectively than what happened at the end of alcohol prohibition. The state of New York simply removed their alcohol laws and said, to hell with you, we're not going to continue to arrest our citizens. A couple of other states followed, and before long, the federal government backed off, and that's exactly where we are. We are at a tipping point in America, and if you folks legalize marijuana this November, it is the beginning of the end of marijuana prohibition. What does all this mean? Well, I think it means on one sense that we are literally very close to victory. I mean, Normal has been at this 41 years, and I think we've seen more political progress in the last 3 years than the first 38 years probably. That's how much momentum we have right now. But it also means we're going to look back and be ashamed, I think, at all of the people's lives we ruined and all the students who didn't get student loans and had to drop out of school and all the people who lost their jobs needlessly. There's an area of privacy, and I want to read this quote because it's a Supreme Court quote, and I want to get it right. In a U.S. Supreme Court case called Lawrence v. Texas, they talked about the privacy provisions of the First Amendment and the liberty interests protected by the Constitution. Justice Anthony Kennedy, writing for the majority, said the following: at the heart of liberty is the right to define one's own concept of existence, of meaning, of the universe, and of the mystery of human life. It is a promise of the Constitution that there is a realm of personal liberty which the government may not enter. Well, folks, let me tell you, we're only incidentally talking about marijuana. We're really talking about personal freedom, that realm where government may not enter. Let's legalize marijuana, Washington. Yeah.